a new generation of personal watercraft are something entirely different. Not only do they skim the surface, but they can dive underwater and can remain submerged at a depth of a meter or more for over a minute. They can also leap into the air and surf the waves. To get to a finished watercraft that's been painted to look like a vintage fighter jet is a labour-intensive process. The first part to be built is the vessel's main body. The mould for the main body is sprayed with a gel coat. This will be the shiny exterior surface of the completed craft. A gauge is used to ensure that the gel is the correct thickness. Once the gel coat has hardened, vinyl ester resin is then brushed onto it. This resin is known for its water resistance. The resin is generously applied all over the hardened gel coat. Chopped strand mat fibre is then draped over the resin. Chopped strand mat is a fabric made of long strands of fiberglass. The binder in it dissolves on contact with the resin, causing the fabric to soften and fit to the contours of the mould. After trimming the excess, the strand mat is completely soaked with more resin, rolling it to remove any air bubbles. This is the top half of the main body mould, which has been lined in the same way, to which a dorsal fin mould is bolted at the rear. The two halves of the mould are then joined. Once in position, they're bolted together. Then more resin is applied to the inside of the mould in preparation for more fiberglass. The next stage involves two sheets of fiberglass that are pulled onto a cutting machine. The top fabric is strong, tightly woven fiberglass, while the bottom is the chopped strand mat that was used earlier. The fiberglass is automatically cut into various shapes and dimensions, each one for a specific part of the diving vessel mould. These two large rectangular pieces will be used on the sides. The fiberglass needs to be applied within an hour before the resin starts to harden. A total of 8 layers are applied, and each one is completely saturated in resin. While the thicker fiberglass material provides strength, the thinner chopped strand mat aids adhesion and helps the fabrics conform to the mold. After curing for 3 hours, the solid, seamless body is complete. It's lifted and placed onto a dolly, where it will remain while other parts of the watercraft are built. The cone-shaped front bumper is next to be made. Only 3 layers of fiberglass are used because the bumper is meant to collapse in the event of a collision. For that reason, it's also known as the vessel's sacrificial nose. Here, a fin is being made. The mold is lined with fiberglass, then liquefied plastic is poured into the cavity. A steel wing shaft is then pushed into the plastic, with its end protruding from the fin. Once the plastic is cured, the shaft will be anchored into place. The other half of the mold, identically filled, is placed on top, and the two parts are bolted together and left to cure. The fins will be supported by a triangular frame made from aluminium square tubing. The parts are clamped to a table, and then the joint is welded. The frame is completed by welding it to its base. The welded seams are ground flush. Holes are drilled on either side in preparation of the next stage. Bushings are clamped and welded into position before other attachments are added. The frame is now complete. To make the diving watercraft's passenger cabin, gel coat is sprayed onto a form, which is then covered with fiberglass. A computer-driven router then carves into marine-grade plywood to produce structural backing for the sides of the cockpit. The part is then coated with an adhesive, as is the outside of the fiberglass cockpit. The plywood piece is then pressed into the glued areas of the cockpit, after which resin is brushed onto the front of the plywood. The cockpit section is cut in two, and both parts are glued to the inside of the main body. Next, adhesive putty is applied to the sacrificial nose cone. It's then slid onto the front of the main body and screwed into place to allow the adhesive to set. All the fiberglass parts of the watercraft are sanded to remove bumps and blemishes. This piece is the engine hatch. Once all sanded, the aluminium frame is then bolted to the floor. This is a test fit to ensure the dimensions are correct. As the frame is installed, dummy wing shafts are used to correctly position it within the vessel. Measurements are taken to confirm that the frame sits plumb to the base of the watercraft. Next, the fit of the hatch frame in the rim around the cockpit is checked. This will be bonded into position later with liquid plastic and putty. After the surface of the craft has been primed ready for its final coat of paint, it's time to fit the powerful engine into the back. This is a dry fit to confirm everything lines up correctly. Next to be connected are the air tubes to the snorkel fins that deliver air to the engine. The engine hatch has also been primed, and this is fitted to the watercraft's main body and is locked in position. Installed into a hole at the rear is the exhaust outlet. Then elevator fins are slid into bushings at the rear. These will control the pitch of the watercraft in the water. Also fitted at the rear is the jet propulsion system. It's now time to fit out the cockpit. First, the control pedals are bolted to the floor, and cables are run to the jet propulsion unit, the elevator fins, and the steering system. The dive fin frame is then reinstalled, which has been powder coated yellow, and the dive fins are connected. Next, the control panel is positioned just above the pedals. This is a metal linkage that runs from the dive fins to a control stick. The stick is then checked to ensure it moves the dive fins easily and correctly. These bucket seats are made of lightweight carbon fiber that minimize the load for added speed. Next is the fitting of the canopy. First, a rubber gasket is tucked into the frame. Then a bead of sealant is added where the gasket mates to the window frame. The vessel's canopy is made of thick aircraft-grade acrylic. It's been tinted to repel the sun's rays and keep the cockpit cooler. The back canopy is also the hatch for accessing the cockpit and climbing into the machine. Finally, an artist does a custom paint job and makes the body beautiful. With the mechanical components reinstalled, this diving watercraft is ready to hit the water. Fasten your seatbelts, it should be quite a ride.